Hi everyone, this side Arohi from Pyfit Technologies, IT Park Mohali. Today we'll study about language translation. We will make one language translator using RNN and sequence-to-sequence model. Now, what is sequence-to-sequence model? So basically, sequence-to-sequence model have two parts. One is encoder and other one is decoder. You can see in this diagram, sequence-to-sequence model have two parts. This is the encoding part. And this is the decoding part. Encoding part is responsible to understand the input, to get the input and process it. And decoding part is responsible to give the output. So you can see over here, so we are giving some input. This is in some other language. We are giving that input to encoder. Encoder will process it. And then decoder is responsible for giving us the output. Right? For these words, decoder gave us this output. So this is how we will be using this RNN and sequence-to-sequence model for language translator. So let's see the example. So today we are developing actually the language translator which we are going to develop today. That will be from French to English. Means we'll give French sentences as input and our language translator will give us output in English. So this is the work of today's task. Okay, so first of all, we are importing all the necessary modules. So after that, over here, you can see in data path variable, I'm reading a data set. So our data set is in the text format right now. So let's see what kind of data is there in this particular file. So I'm opening this data path variable in read mode as if, and I'm reading that file content in lines variable. So let's print out the line variable and see the data. So this is the data which is present in that fra.txt file. So over here you can see we have data, but this data is not clean, this data is not proper. So let's perform some pre-processing on the data to make this data proper for the functionality. So next task is, first of all, what we want is, let's divide the data line-wise line and then we'll further see what to do on it. So over here, I have created one function with the name of two lines and we'll give one parameter over here. And this parameter is basically, we'll give the lines variable over here. The line variable, which is storing this whole data set. So when we call this function, we'll give here lines, right? The variable which we have used above. So in sense variable, what I'm doing here is text.strip and dot split by slash n. That simply means we want to divide the lines on the basis of this new line character. Wherever this new line character is present in the data set, from there new line will start. So if you'll see this data set, so we have multiple, you know, we have this slash t also, backslash t also there, and if you'll see this data clearly, you can see there are multiple backslash n's also. So means we are dividing the lines on the basis of backslash n, right? Once lines get divided, then we are performing next functionality on it, and what we are saying, we want to split the data on the basis of backslash t, right? First of all, we are separating the data on the basis of backslash n, and then once sentence gets splitted, then we are finding this backslash t, and on the basis of this, we are splitting our data. Now, this function is ready. Now, let's call this function. So I'm calling this function in a variable with the name of fra_ing, and two lines is this function name. So I'm calling that function over here, and the argument, the data I'm passing it is lines. So lines is a variable which I've used above where I've read whole file, right? So now we have applied the function on this lines variable and we are storing the results in fra_ing. So in this variable, now let's see, like, after performing this whole functionality, what kind of data now we are getting. So colon 5 means I want to see the first 5 records of our data set. So when you see the output, see this kind of output now we are having. So for every record, we have three columns, right? After this, new record has started. Go, va, and this is a related some information. So the go simply means this is the English word. Va means this is a French word. Means for this English word, this is the French translation. For high English word, this is the translation in French. And we have one other column. This column is actually not useful for us. So later on, we'll delete this particular column. Right. So now we have data in this format. We have English version and we have French version of the word. And now in the next line, what I'm doing here is I'm just converting my data into an array. See, over here, this data is in the form of list, and now I'm converting it in the form of array, right? So let's further see more things about the data, means like how many different records were there in our data set. So by just writing shape, you can directly see like these many different records were there. Means we have 1,75,623 different records, and every record have three columns. One column is for English version of the word, one column is for French version of the word, and third column is containing this particular information, right? So now see, as this data set have 1,75,000 something records, so I don't want to use all the records because that will, you know, slow down the process. Let's see the functionality on less data. So what I'm doing here is I'm only using first 90,000 records for this particular task. Means if you want to use the whole data set, you can use it, but that will take more, you know, time to process the values. So I'm just taking 90,000 records and I'm solving this problem on the basis of that. So I'm storing the first 90,000 records in frank variable only. Means I'm updating the previous variable only, right? So now the one more thing which I've told you is this third column is not useful, right? Means the first two columns are important, English and a French word, but this third column is not important. Now let's delete this third column. So what I'm doing here is simply I'm choosing the column which is at 0 index and which is at 1 index, and the third column which is at second index, this is at 0 index, this is at first index, and this is at second index. So what I'm doing here is I'm simply choosing the first two indexes which will give us this data. Now we have English and French word, right? So now the further process is, so if you see over here, see after go we have a full stop, after high we have a full stop, and after run we have this exclamation symbol, and in this side also after every word we have some punctuation. So now we need to perform data cleaning, means we want to remove punctuation. So for that, and I want to delete the punctuation, and how I'm deleting the punctuation? For single record, means for 0th index, the data which is present in 0th index, means the first column, right? That is storing after removing punctuation, I'm storing in this, and after removing punctuation of this first column, I'm storing the results in here, right? Now let's check the output after removing punctuation. So this is the output we are getting. See, over here after every word we have some punctuation, but over here we are not having that punctuation. Now the next task is removing, means converting your data into a lowercase. Over here if you see all the records, all the words are starting with the uppercase, but now we want to convert our data into a lowercase. So for that, simply dot lower method, I'm using dot lower method on both the columns at 0th column and first column, and this is how you'll see the output, right? So you can even see here, initially in the starting of the data set, we have language, this is a single word over here and over here single word, but later on we have sentences also. Means let's suppose if an English sentence is, I know that you are a teacher, so this is the whole sentence in French means we in this particular data set have single words also, and this data set worked upon the sentences also. So this is the data. Now we have clean data. The next task is, if you remember, I've told you in every class, like the next step is to convert your data into numbers, means to convert your data words into, means first of all divide the lines, divide the sentences into words using tokenizer, and once those sentences got divided into words, then convert those words into numbers. And I have told you one more thing, that always remember that each sentence in your data set should be of same length. For that we will be using padding sequences, means we will fill zeros just to make the length of every sentence same. So all these things I'm going to do in next few columns, cells. So tokenization, we have already studied about it. In a tokenizer variable, I'm calling this tokenizer function, and then we will fit data in it, right? So basically we have two separate columns, 0th column and 1st column. So we need to call this tokenizer two times. So that's why I've created a function, so that we can call this function, multiple times. There is no need to write the whole code again and again, right? So I have a tokenization function. We are calling tokenizer, and then we are fitting a text in it. Remember, we are just fitting a text in it. We are not converting into numbers right now. So first of all, let's perform this much of functionality on both the columns, means the English column and the column which is storing French data. So ENG tokenizer will store the tokenization detail of English only. So I'm calling this tokenization function over here, fraeng and 0th column. So this is the data, means the first column, this first column I'm talking about here. So we are giving that, and then what we are doing over here is English length is equal to 8. What this 8 means over here? See, 8 simply means, if you remember from your previous classes, we always decide, like in a single sentence, how many different words can be there, means we always fix the length of every sentence, right? So what we are saying over here is, like in every sentence, maximum number of words can be 8. And if you remember this line simply means, why I'm starting from plus 1? Because 0 we have stored, we want to basically check the vocabulary size, means how many different words are present in the first column, how many different English words are present in first column. So we want to count the vocabulary length. So how we can count the length? By using a length method, right? And why I'm doing plus one over here? Because we want to start the counting from one only. We don't want to start from zero, because zero is the reserved, zero is reserved for padding sequences. So, right, and over here we are saying, like in each sentence, only 8 words can present. That means our motive is to make every sentence of 8 word length, right? So, how many different vocabulary words are present in English over here? So, 8,402. This same functionality will perform for French column also. So over here we are calling tokenization. We are doing tokenization. Tokenization is a function which we have over here, and we are performing it on first column. 0th column is storing English data, and first column is storing French data. And again, we want to know the vocabulary size, and we are setting the length to 8. Why 8? Because what we want is English sentences and French sentences both should have same word length in each sentence. So that's why I have set 8 over here, and French vocabulary size is this. So over here, if you'll see, when we are checking the vocabulary length of French. So we have this much of length, and in English vocabulary we have this length, right? Now, till now we have only fit the data. Now, if you want to convert them into numbers, so if you remember, we always perform text to sequences. Text to sequences will convert your sentences into what it does is it will convert your sentences into sequence of numbers, and we are then using paired sequence on it. And paired sequence, if you remember, in paired sequence what we are writing over here is length, means how many words we want to have in single line. On the basis of that only this paired sequence will work, right? So again, we have stored this whole work in one function. So that simply means we need to call this function for English and for English and French data both, right? Then the next task is to train. If we want to make a model, then we need a data to train our machine, and then we'll be having some data on which we want to test our machine. So what I'm doing here is we have two variables. See carefully over here. Till now we have studied different examples, and in every example we always use four variables over here: train x, train y, test x and test y. But over here I'm using two variables only, and we are splitting our data into train and test. And from where we are getting the data? This is the array where we have both the columns, x and y column. That means, okay, what is input and output over here? Input, in the starting of this today's session, I've told you, like, we will give French sentence as an input, and that means French word or French sentence will be our input, means that will be our X, and this will give us, it will translate that particular sentence into English. That means Y simply means English sentences are Y. And in this fra ink array we have two different columns. One is storing English data and one is storing French data. Test size 0.2, that simply means we are using 20% of data for testing purpose, right? So from this train and from this test, we are dividing our data into train X and train Y, test X and test Y over here. In code sequence, you remember the function which I've used here, we hadn't called it yet. So I'm calling this function over here in code sequence, and on which data we want to encode over here? Fra tokenizer. What this is X, that means we're talking about input. Input which we want to use for training our algorithm. And what is input in our case? French sentences. And where we have tokenized the French sentences, we have performed tokenization on French sentences in fra tokenizer variable. And then fra length simply means, okay, let me go back above and show you fra tokenizer. So this was the fra tokenizer. That means we have done tokenization on French words or sentences in it, and then fra length is 8. From these two variables I'm calling there. Yeah, over here. Fra tokenizer will get the tokenization of French words over here. Fra length will be 8. Means we are telling, basically what we are doing is we are performing encode sequence function, and we are saying that every sentence which belongs to this first column, that means for French sentences, every sentence should be of length 8. And train Y simply means English data is stored in this train Y. So that means English tokenizer. From English tokenizer we are getting data over here. English length again means 8, means every sentence can have maximum length of 8, right? Train 0, data coming from there. So this train is this. This train is storing 80% of data. That means from this train, we are getting 80% of data, and we are storing that data into train X and train Y. In the same way, test X and test Y means the remaining 20% data, we need to perform this encode sequence function on it also. So that's why test X means input, FRA tokenizer will call here, FRA length over here, and this is how we dividing the train data into train X and train Y, test X and test Y. Now on the basis of train X and train Y, we will train our model. So let's build the model first of all. So I've told you in the beginning of our today's session, we will be using sequence to sequence model. And I've told you, like, in sequence to sequence model, we have encoder and decoder. Encoder accepts the input and processes it, and decoder is responsible for showing us the output, right? So I have created a function with the name of define model. And whenever I want to use this model, these are the important parameters which we need to give. Let's see what are the parameters. Invocab means input vocabulary on which we want to, means which sentence we want to translate, right? So obviously model needs an input, then only it will perform the functionality. Outvocab means output. Invocab, input for model. Outvocab will give us the output. In time steps, if you remember, see time step, okay, let me explain you in a very simple way. Over here, just remember, in steps means max length of words which we have decided for input vocabulary. So I have told you, like, what we want is for English sentences also and for French sentences also. What we want is every sentence can have maximum of 8 words. So this in steps is that max word in input, out step means max word in output, units means neurons. Alright, so let's build the model. So first layer is sequential layer. Now we want to add the layers in it. So simply model.add. Embedding layer, embedding layer and LSTM layer. These two layers are working as a encoder. Remember, sequence to sequence model have two parts, encoder and decoder. These two, first layer, embedding layer and LSTM layer, these two layers are acting as a encoder. Let's see, this embedding layer is accepting the input. Right? See, we are not writing output vocab over here because these two layers are responsible for input, processing input. So that's why from this parameter, input parameter is only coming, output parameter is not coming. Units means neurons and input length is equal to in time steps. That simply means length of a sentence. Right? This mask zero is true, we are using it. So LSTM model means we are telling how many neurons we will later on, when while calling this function, we are just creating a function. While calling this function, we will mention like how many neurons we want to have over here, right? Clear? Now encoder, sequence to sequence model have encoder and decoder, and the functionality of encoding is done. Now these two lines perform the functionality of decoder. Sequence to sequence, sequence model have decoder part also, which is responsible to show us the output. So these two layers are responsible for showing output. And what we are doing here is we are adding LSTM and dense layer. So if you remember, dense layer simply means fully connected layer, the last layer, and it will always have how many neurons? It depends upon the number of classes. And over here we are writing out vocab. Out vocab simply means the vocabulary size of English, right? So how many neurons we want to have in a final layer, it will depend upon the how many different words are there in English list, right? And softmax function, activation function, this, and then we are returning a model. So after, okay, and this repeat vector means the repeat vector is responsible for repeating the input. And right, why we are, it will repeat the input how many times? on the basis of outsteps. And outstep simply means 8, right? We have decided this value above 8. Means it will repeat this process 8 times, and then that data will go to decoder, and decoder will work on it and give us final output. So this is the function, this is the model. Now we define a model. Now let's call the model. So this is a model, model define model, right? So what is our input vocab? In this model, I've told you like these are the mandatory parameters. In vocab, so our input vocabulary is stored in fra vocab size. Let's go above and see what is it. Fra vocab size. Over here. Remember, we have checked the vocabulary size for French and we have checked the vocabulary size for English. Vocabulary size of English is this and vocabulary size for French is this. Means this is the input size fra vocab size and this will be our output size, English vocab size. So let's go back to our model again. Fra vocab size means input. Input, we will give input in French. So that's why we have written French vocab size in the starting. And then output vocab. We want output in the form of English. So that means we need to define here like what would be the size of the vocabulary of English. So we have calculated above, we have counted above and we are calling it here. And then in time steps and out time steps. So this I have told you, fra length means ki how many different words can a sentence have, maximum words, and how many different words can English have. And 512 units, I've told you neurons, and how many neurons we are using? 512 means over here also 512 neurons we are using, over here also we are using 512 neurons. So once we call the model, now let's compile it. And the optimizer we are using in language translator, we are using RMS optimizer. Why we are using RMS optimizer? Because according to the people on, the persons who have worked on this line, they say like RMS optimizer work well. So that's why I'm using RMS prop optimizer and the learning rate I'm using is this. So now let's compile our model. While compiling our model, just see here. We know that deep learning always accepts and gives output in the form of one hot encoding, right? But we are making language translator. That simply means when one sentence we are giving to our algorithm, we want a proper output of that. But by default, deep learning gives us output in the form of one hot encoding. So why we are using this sparse categorical cross entropy? So that it avoids that one hot encoding step, right? So that's why I'm using this particular function over here. Now let's train the model. So model.fit, by using model.fit we can train the model. Train x and train y we are giving. Epochs 10 and batch size is this. So after 10 epochs, let's predict. So model.predict classes, we are storing the results in predicts. On 20% of the data we are testing it. So when you'll see the results, so this kind of output we are getting means these are the sentences, but these sentences are in the form of numbers. But we don't want numbers. We want like these numbers get converted into words and we want proper sentences as a English sentences as an output. So for that, what we can do? In our previous class and in our last 2-3 classes, I've told you, I've explained you how to convert these numbers into words by simply using a loop where we will be having two variables, word and index, right? It means key and value pair, and from tokenizer dot word index dot item means from tokenizer, we are using word index dot item method, which will give us index and their corresponding words, and using this, for every corresponding index, we will be having its corresponding word. Now we have words for every numeric value, but those words are not in the form of sentence, right? Means we know this means 8 is equal to this particular word, 18 is equal to this particular word, but those words are not in a proper format right now. So, but we need proper sentences. So for that, what I've done is we have created one blank list, this predict underscore text. In this list, we will be storing those proper sentences. And this is the loop. After using this loop, we will have this list appended at the last. This list will have those proper sentences. Let's see some data of that. I'm just creating a data frame. Actual means test 0 have an actual test data, and in predicted, predict test, the list which we have just created over here, which is storing the results properly. And let's see the output. I want to see 15 samples, so it is showing me 15 samples. So these are the English sentences for corresponding French values, and these are the predicted result. Means for this particular the French sentence which is at this index, its English translation is this, but our algorithm is giving us this translation, right? So that means this is not proper, right? Over here also this is not proper, this is giving us half information in prediction. Over here this is I really want to, and our algorithm is saying I really want to see you. This is again not a complete information but half information. Means in some of the records you are getting proper information in prediction, but in some of the record you are not getting proper information. That simply means you need to train your model for more time. I have just trained it for 10 times, at least train it for 50 times. See, this is not a fixed figure. You can try with different epochs value and then see the results. So, right, this is how language translator works. Thank you.